So very famous character, Chatur. I'm not going to speak the definition of technology like Chatur, but for me, technology is just a simple thing, easily available, fast, user-friendly, safe, error-free, and most important, it should be cost-benefit ratio. So what my auxiliary principle when I'm managing the patient, I'm not going to forget these important things. So detailed case history, detailed examinations, clinical correlation of each lab reports and technology lab report is only to support my clinical diagnosis. I'm not going to ask the lab reports and get the diagnosis through the lab reports. That is the prime most thing. What my practical difficulties in ER? For an example, we just take an example of myocardial infarction patient. In the era of 30, 40 years back, when biomarkers is not available, the technology is not available, some old ECGs, right? A patient came with the ECG with a small chest pain. Sometime even the myocardial infarction or the ischemia can be present with the normal ECG. A patient already having an old pattern and no new fresh changes. We are confused whether it is a cardiac issue or not. And then once the era is developed, the troponin I, the CPK-MB, all are evolved, myoglobulin, and then we rampantly use. But for an example, acute myocardial infarction, severe chest pain, ST elevation, reciprocal changes with all clinical data. I'm not going to ask the troponin T and then thrombolyze the patient. No, the chest pain and the ECG changes is suffice for me. So I don't want to share that thing. But yes, definitely, so many patients with LBVB chest pain, typical chest pain, some hemodynamical instability, whether it is having a just unstable angina or non-ST elevation MI or ST elevation MI, we do need a biomarker, some supportive lab evidence to come to the conclusion. So same in a sepsis, which is a huge wide term. So many confusing patients you are getting in a E-ward. The undiagnosed shock you received with very, very minimal few clinical histories, no clear cut telltale sign on a clinical examination. Some old patients, like patients having a trauma, burns, post-operative. And in that your patient start throwing the fever and you don't know whether it is infective or non-infective origin. The patient is on organ transplant. The patient with a chronic illness is already having a chronic renal failure. I just received a patient who is having a DCM. 4 years back is a stroke. He's having a CKD. So all his organs, main organs are damaged. And this guy is presented to us without history of fever, nothing. Just a 70 by 40 blood pressure, weakness, complaint, no urine output since 48 hours. Now, whether it is a cardiac, whether it is hemorrhagic shock, whether it is septic, how to diagnose? And surprisingly, after 48 hours, his blood culture is turned out to be positive. And this typical cases, we required some supportive systems which give a quicker and faster idea about what exactly the patient is. Otherwise, what we end up in? We end up in a lot of fear. Then the fear factor is more important for us. We start prescribing the antibiotic just because of fear, probably this could be a cardiac issue or this could be a septic issue. Let's start and then we will decide. But after 2 or 3 days, we don't have even courage, guts to stop the antibiotics. And sometimes we unnecessarily continue the antibiotic for a long period of time. We want this all close. So this is lecture for it. So forget about the older definition where the SARS is there, where you are calculating the SARS, where the septicemia is the word. Now everything has been taken out. So newer definition is clear-cut life-threatening organ dysfunction caused by dysregulated host response to infection. So there is a two important thing, dysregulated host response and infection. Organ dysfunction is calculated by the SOFA score, very much aware about it, I'm not going to go deep detail, and clinical criteria. So infection plus two or more parameters in SOFA score that give you idea about the septic patients. And patient with the septic shock means a sepsis with persistent hypotension requiring prolonged inotropic support, which blood pressure is low, 65 less than that, or serum lactate is high. So this is newer definition and what my target goal is. Then everyone is teaching me, doctor, this is the septic patient, give early antibiotic. Early fluid resuscitation is the key role. Early target reduction on the lactate. Early source control, but what the early is? Early is the 1 hour. I have to start this, all these things, antibiotics, fluid resuscitations early, within 1 hour, and my target to reduction in lactate level normal, within 6 hours. But when I am confused, my lab report will be there in 30 minutes or 3 hour, 24 hour. And typical this type of patients, which we already discussed, where we are in confused whether it is aseptic or not, how we achieve the early target. Blood culture is, which is a gold standard, only 50% positive on most of the patients, and will get the report a positive after 48 hours. So what the early detection is, what the solution? So solution is biomarker, as we know, like the cancer, we're having a lot more biomarkers, cardiac, we're having a lot more biomarkers, some abdominal condition, a lot more biomarkers are there. And that is how the technology come in picture. As I already mentioned, the sepsis having a two things, a dysregulated host and an infection. So there's a two main component. So one is a pathogen associated molecule proteins or a damage associated, the bone tissue which is got damaged during that process, damage associated molecular pattern. So out of this, so many biomarkers is available to detect the sepsis. Around 80 biomarkers are there, but practically what we are using and what we want. So what we want is, we want a very high specific, high sensitive, very good negative predictive value, good having a prognostications, which having a good incidence and association with the mortality, early availability of result and early operating system, which exactly technology tools which we want. So current practice biomarkers are a WBC count and the tool count, which you all knows and all agree. Always you got a varying results, not every time is comparing with the clinical data. High sensitive CRP, procalcitonin, IL-6, presepsin, which is newer, and your culture from either blood or any tissue sites or tissue fluids where exactly you are suspecting the infection. So high sensitive CRP, we all know CRP is not a marker of infection, it is just a marker of inflammation. And we all use this CRP very frequently, very much, but the trend is important. But yes, still for the diagnosis purpose, CRP having a very less value, very less specificity and sensitivity. At present we all use the procalcitonin. Now what the procalcitonin is? This is the procalcitonin. This is the calcitonin substance, which is the precursor of the calcitonin. Now you think of inflammation cascade, infection cascade, and you never found a calcitonin or the procalcitonin over this sector. It's some kind of association. Theoretically, still not proved why the procalcitonin is high in infection. It's kind of response. It's kind of response to the body to it. Now we take procalcitonin and the value of it. So we is having a, nowadays what we think of, that is having a very good negative predictive value. Means if your procalcitonin is less than 0.1, you can damnly sure tell that there is no any bacterial infection involved in that patient. If the value is 0.1 to 0.25, and you will not require any antibiotic less than 0.1, but if between the 0.1 to 0.25, there could be some infection, check the clinically, but you can still discredit the antibiotic. When your level is 0.25 to 5, there can be a small local infection which is not a systemic infection, right? And more than 0.5 to 2, if the systemic infection possibility is high, 2 to 10, where the systemic possibility is infection high and patient is in the sepsis, septic shock, and more than 10 is very bad septic shock patient is in. Now what the problems lie? We all see the data, and data is always confusing, but still we rely on the Cochrane. And is having a very good impact factor. So what the Cochrane is telling me about the procalcitonin is, procalcitonin evaluation effective in reducing mortality and time receiving antibiotic therapy in adult with the sepsis. So authors conclude, so all evidence is very low and moderate quality, insufficient sample, poor outcome. So it is not giving clear cut support to your data of mortality. That is number one. Particularly procalcitonin shows some results in a particular patient with a low respiratory infection, acute respiratory infection, where meta-analysis shows procalcitonin guided therapy and the duration of antibiotic can lower the risk of mortality, lower the antibiotic consumption, lower risk of antibiotic related side effects. But what is the problem with the procalcitonin? Which was used very rampantly, now suddenly we are not much rely on the procalcitonin. One, hypothetically, relation of precitin with the sepsis is not associated good. PCT value can be high without infection in a trauma patient, burn patient, and post-operative patient. So in a patient with the trauma. And if you want a really negative predictive value, negative predictive value, baseline value, in a normal patient, in a trauma patient, in a burn patient, in a post-operative patient, all baseline value are different. So there is no any universal negative predictive value. It could be in a normal patient, I came with a cough, khasi, and my PCT is 0.1. It could be a viral infection. But suppose having a trauma, a 0.2 or 0.24 could be a good negative predictive value. So there is no any universally acceptable negative predictive value for every single disease. Second, it can came negative in a fungal, viral, and atypical diseases. Once you ask the PCT, it will be available in a very good reputed pathology lab within 6 to 12 hours. So what you are going to do within the 6 to 12 hours. So a quick test, which is known as a PCTQ, is available. But the limitation of PCTQ is it give you only 3 results. Whether it is less than 0.5, it is 0.5 to 2, or it is more than 2 to 5, right? But our interest is whether it should be less than 0.1 or not. I want a good negative predictive value, which is not possible with the PCTQ also. And false high result in a CKD patient and patient with the renal dysfunction. So do we have a solutions? So recently we start using this molecule, which is known as a preception. Now you see the cascade. So whenever the bacteria came in the host body, it start releasing the PL lipopolysaccharides. LPS, and this lipopolysaccharides is attached with the lipopolysaccharides binding protein, and this both combination is go and attach with this CD4 molecule, which is attached on the CD4 cell, and that activate the toll like receptor 4 and MD2, which activate releasing whole cascade, start releasing the chemotactic agents, complements, and it start phagocyting the substance. Once this substance is been used, it been excreted and released in the body, which is known as a soluble CD14, which is a 55 dalton, and subsequently with the proteolytic mechanism of the body, it get destroyed in a 14 subunit of CD14, which is precepsin. Here you can clearly see this directly clearly attached with your infection, where the bacteria has came in. Your CD14 solution substance is attached, it's activate your cells, WBC cells, and then this is all precepsin. Then your interleukin in come in picture 1, 6, 8, then the synthesis of PCT and the CRP come in picture. So from this diagnosis, from this cartoon, we come to know that with this precepsin, we can early diagnose the sepsis. It is a more sensitive and specific biomarkers in sepsis. It can detect bacteria and the fungus also, right? It's rise early than other biomarkers, does not shows unspecific increase in and not falsely false positive results. It's having a, if you strategize the severity of the septic disease, there's an excellent correlation with the all your score is less, Apache score and SOFA score. This prognostication power, when we combine with the clinical score, is so high. Serial precepsin level is also demonstrated the response to therapy and predict the favorable outcome. It's also helpful in the neonatal, and recently in a cardiac study, a patient with undergone the cardiac surgery, and you found a precepsin level and compare with the other scoring system which at present we are using, because every patient's relative ask you what the outcome of my relative is, my patient is. So where you need to exactly tell what exactly the ratio of the incidence of the mortality. And if you see the precepsin having a highest area under curve even compared to the Apache and SOFA, and we all know the higher lactate level is associated with the mortality. More the level of lactate in the septic shock patient, the less chance of survival. So when they compare a SOFA score combination, SOFA score precepsin and SOFA score with the lactate, even in that the prediction of mortality is good with the precepsin. If you see a level of precepsin and consequently you get the precepsin level, you can comparatively retrogradely check that in a non-survivable, these are non, red one is the non-survivable patient, these are survival patient, where the survival patient's level is low and the non-survivable patient's level is high, compared to the PCT where where you see this totally haphazard pattern you will be found in the procalcitonin. So directly associate, if the higher pre-sepsin, higher the chance of mortality. And how the technologies come in picture, we routinely want this to be at a bedside, this to be at the emergency ward, like the CART test or something. The company came with the path fast where exited the magnetic particles coated with the antibiotics, and you just need 100 micro ml of blood, either plasma or the blood of the patient, to be mixed it. So this is our target molecule. This is blue color, blue green color is a pre-sepsin. This is attached to this magnetic molecule, and there's a separate magnet that segregate it and separate from the rest of the plasma. And from the chemical reaction, within 15 minutes we can able to come to know what the level of pre-sepsin. So it is a fast, effective, and it won't need a kind of very expertise or the technological person or the technical person to be available. Any single patient person can do this test within short period of time. Within 15 minutes, a very small amount of blood you need, you can get a 6 tests at a time. All tests been ready within 15 minutes. It is ideal for the emergency room. It is a very good sensitivity and high negative predictive value. What other biomarkers are available, which is still not practically used? So cytokines, cytokine interleukin 6, still it is an inflammatory marker, so it does not give you a specific diagnostic tool for the sepsis, but prognostication do use. So many cities in the country start doing IL-6, but still it is on the scientific, on the study basis. Interleukin 8 and the rest of the biomarkers is available, which is still not giving you a perfect tool of diagnosis. Yes, it will give you a prognostication markers. And if you compare this all the biomarkers starting from the top to bottom, you can see the pre-sepsin having a highest area under curve, highest sensitivity, specificities compared to PCT, highest positive predictive value and highest negative predictive value. So at present, PCT is only with Apollo, only with the Max Hospital. It is still in a developing phase. We will see in a future and it will be available. But this definitely one of the tool which give us a good technological substance which help us in early diagnosis of sepsis. Thank you.